1986, a year to remember in Gator football history. A three-year building program had Coach Haskins' staff with high aspirations and goals for 1986. First was to win the Eastern Division title of the newly formed Allegheny Mountain League. An 8-1 campaign last season made this year's team set for itself the goal of an undefeated season. The taste of defeat from that final game of the 1985 season had left the Gators unfulfilled in their bid for a perfect record. This, the 1986 football season, was to be the year of the Gator. And what a year it turned out to be. This program of 1986 offensive and defensive highlights is dedicated to the members and coaches of the Gators. Their hard work, dedication, discipline, and most of all, desire to be King of the Mountain, set the tone for what this season came to be, a time of working, growing, and learning how to be successful.
Technical difficulties didn't allow us to get the first half of the Cotter Sport football game. You'll have to bear with us on this half. Port Allegany did jump out to a big lead at halftime versus the Cotter Sport Falcons. Typical of that defense that was number one in the Big 30. Dickie Sherwood picking off a pass and threading his way down the sideline towards the goal line. Even though he stepped out of bounds, it was a big moment in the Cotter Sport game. Another highlight, of course, being touchdowns, and there was plenty of them in this blowout. Here we have Brian McCusker calling signals, and a beautiful rollout, and he heads for that goal line. One of the many fine plays Brian McCusker had that night. And all season long, we were treated to the strong foot of Torrey Daniels and Tony Schell. And here Tony Schell lines up the extra point and puts it through for a Gator lead. In the fourth quarter, the second team got to play in this ball game, and Jimmy Stair was in at quarterback. Here we see Stair calling signals. Beautiful fake, rolling out to his right, and he throws a strike to Scott McDowell for the final score. Cotter Sport was ranked one of the top small schools coming into this ballgame, and the Gators thoroughly dominated in the final score, Port Allegany 35-0.
Next, we journey to Ottawa Eldred the following week. Here, we're about to see one of the many touchdowns scored here. Paul Robbins across for the TD. It was during this game, rather sluggish for the Gators, that we saw them showcase Jimmy Stair, a future quarterback. Right now, it's Torrey Daniels up with the point and through for the uprights. Maybe it was the team that they were meeting, an Ottawa Eldred team that had not shown very much this year, but the Gators were somewhat slow. Here Jimmy Stair is, pitched to Dickie Sherwood, and RJ is off and running once again. One of his many fine plays, 25 yards on that carry, as he began a season that saw him roll up over 1,000 yards for this 1986 season. Right now, it is Brian McCusker rolling, throwing, and TD. As you can see by the scoreboard, the Gators now have jumped out in front to an 18-0 lead over the Ottawa Eldred Terriers. Once again, the Gators on the move, and it's Jimmy Stair throwing into the end zone, and there it is, Brian Fryer taking that one across for the TD. Again, Jimmy Stair, as we said, showcased during this game, had plenty of time to show the throwing ability that is being developed by this young man. Another perfect strike. There is the final score, 41-0 over the Terror of Ottawa Eldred.
The next game was against the Bradford Central Christian Ramblers, and this was to turn out to be a big defensive struggle. Here's one of the many fine tackles Paul Robbins made throughout the season, and then one of these tackles made him Big 30 Player of the Year on defense. Here's another defensive gem, this time by Jimmy Stair from his halfback position, intercepting a pass by Frontino, the Bradford Central quarterback. One of the many tough runs all year by Scott Gearhart, who was an unsung hero in that backfield for the Gators. And defense was the name of this ball game, but Port Allegany was able to punch the ball in numerous times on this afternoon. Here we have Brian McCusker calling signals, and that counter play that was so famous this year, and Paul Robbins running the ball down to the 1 yard line. And here we see the drive being capped off by Paul Robbins' touchdown plunge. Port Allegany backfield was rated number one in the Big 30. They ground out more yards than any other backfield. And their offense was rated number one in scoring. Here we have Brian McCusker, inside handoff again. Counterplay coming at you. And again, it's Paul Robbins with a big gain. And again, we showcase the Gator defense. Quarterback being rushed by Track Kyle, who played spectacularly all year long. And again, a big interception by Brian McCusker from that safety spot to stop another Bradford Central Christian drive. And this play here is just typical of one of the many fine and exciting plays we saw from Gator football in 1986. Who said running up the middle can't be exciting? Scott Gearhart with another one of his long touchdown runs this year. Did see a few mistakes made, and we don't like to highlight those, but this leads into one of the better defensive stands we've seen all year. A miscue on a punt return, fumble, and Bradford Central Christian recovers on about the Gator 2 yard line. It looked like the Gator shutout streak was about to end. They had already shut out their first two opponents and were looking for number three. Here we have Torrey Daniels making a big hit on the ball carry to throw him for a loss. Again, Bradford tries to dent that line. Quarterback rolling out, thinks he can get outside, and again that Gator defense toughens up, and he throws him for a loss. Third down, and again Bradford trying to score. And again, it's Torrey Daniels in the middle of that Gator defense that stops him in his tracks. Fourth down and goal to go. One more time, and the quarterback is thrown for a big loss. This is Torrey Daniels' finest series this year as a Gator, and he showed why he deserved to be on that Big 30 All-Star team. And a little icing on the cake here. Again, Brian McCusker calling signals. And one of the fine runs Dickie Sherwood made this year en route to 1,000 yards. Sherwood up the middle, touchdown, 21 yards. The extra point. And that made the final score, Port Allegany 20 and Bradford Central Christian 0. Then it was on to Youngsville for the fourth ball game of the year. Port Allegany coming into this game with three straight shutouts. And this play was indicative of what type of afternoon it was going to be. A fumble on the first possession, Youngsville recovers. They come out with a hurry-up offense, and it kind of caught the Gators by surprise, as you will see momentarily. Youngsville quarterback will come out in the shotgun formation, something you rarely see on a first down. He does a little run off to his right, and he stopped for a loss. Second play coming up, same type of deal, but this time Youngsville does not huddle. And again, the Gator defense just isn't quite set, even though they do stop this play. A little run to his left this time, and down he goes. The next play was a big one, and it was perhaps the biggest play the Gators had seen all year against their vaunted defense. Defense was playing shutout ball for 12 quarters, and they were determined not to let anyone score. But here they come up with a little trick pass, and the receiver's open down the sideline. Brian McCusker finally runs him down at the 15-yard line. that Gator streak again was in jeopardy. But the Gators did hold, and they finally got their offense untracked. Again, we see Brian McCusker calling signals. One of the few times this year, nice, beautiful pass. Right down the middle, first and 10, Port Allegany. Later on in that drive in the second quarter, Port Allegany was able to break out on top. Again, a quick hitter up the middle, Paul Robbins, touchdown Port Allegany. And again, they were ahead 6-0 at this point. And Tony Schell's extra point made it 7-0 Gators. Port Allegany was playing with three important members injured in this ball game. The defense did play very, very well, as we can see here on this sack. Eric Stauffer and Brett Kleinen on that tackle. Again, Gator pride coming through. Again, Youngsville trying to go to the airways. And a beautiful interception this time by Dave Baumgartner across the middle. First and 10, Port Allegany. Again, that defense is held. But here's one of the flukiest, quote-unquote, plays of the 1986 campaign. Brian McCusker calling signals. Steps out to call timeout, and the ball is snapped. Youngsville recovers down on the 4-yard line. First and 10, Youngsville. That had the commentators a little bit agitated. And as you will see here, coach or two from the Gators also very, very upset. Now we get the timeout. Only it's about 30 seconds too late. And here comes Coach Turner. And he gets a little vociferous here. Bingo. That will take the ball down to about the 2-yard line. And now we'll really see what this Gator defense is made of. This is the first threat of the afternoon by Youngsville. Play up the middle goes absolutely nowhere. Defense is really stiffened. Second play, quarterback keeper around left end. Again, he goes nowhere. Thrown for a yard loss on this play by Jimmy Stair. Third and goal. Again, a quarterback keeper and nowhere. That brings up fourth down. Finally, Youngsville scores a touchdown. Even that was questionable, as you can tell by where the gentleman was laying. And Youngsville goes for two, and they get it. And the Gators find themselves behind for the first time in 1986 by a score of 8-7. Time for the offense to go to work. And who do we see but Dickie Sherwood running for the yard marker. First and 10 Gators. Port Allegany did not score on that. And now they have to hold Youngsville out. And again, it's the big Gator defense led by Big 30 Defensive Player of the Year, Paul Robbins, coming up with a big interception. Again, this is in the fourth quarter now, and Youngsville punting their own end zone. And again, it's Paul Robbins looking to his right and heading for the sideline. Takes the ball down inside the 10-yard line. Inside handoff, touchdown, Port Allegany. And again, Tony Schell with the extra point. And the final score, Port Allegany 14, Youngsville 8. Next up for the Gators was Sheffield Wolverines. Port Allegany coming into this game, of course, with a record of 4-0. But the shutout streak had been ended, and the Gators had a lot to prove in this ball game. And it started out on the right foot with Ray Roberts returning the opening kickoff big for the Gators. First and 10. In this game, Paul Robbins scores from inside close, and the Gators jump out to a 7-0 lead. again, it's that potent Gator offense. That all-too-familiar split formation. This time, Brian McCusker on one of his vaunted keepers for a big game for the Gators. We did have a few technical difficulties on this game, so just bear with us. Brian McCusker pitching back to Dickie Sherwood again, looking for that opening and running the ball down to the 1 yard line. Of course, nothing is about to stop this young man from scoring his touchdown. And the Gators jump off to a big lead. The extra point by Daniels was good. Tony Daniels was back in, Tory Daniels playing back in this ball game after being injured and out for the Youngsville game. Again, Brian McCusker back to pass. Beautiful completion over the middle. The number 80, Brett Klein, and a big first down for the Gators. And Ray Roberts up the middle this time. And that deep Gator backfield again finds the end zone. This ball game, Port Allegany came out to show that that Youngsville fiasco was a fluke. Again, beautiful ball handling. Jimmy Stair, and this time looking for one of his favorite receivers, number 83, Scott McDowell, for the touchdown. Final score of this ball game, Port Allegany 34, Sheffield nothing. And the big game of the year up to this point was the game with Ridgeway. And it didn't start out on a very good note. Port Allegany lost the coin toss. Ridgeway elected to receive. And what a big opening play this turned out to be. Tory Daniels kicked deep down the middle to John Piakowicz, who takes the ball straight up the middle. One player to beat, and he's around him. And the only person that has a chance to catch him is Paul Robbins. And that's not about to occur. So for the second time in 1986, Port Allegany finds themselves behind in a ball game, 6-0. But on the ensuing kickoff, we saw what the Gator team was made of in 1986. To Dick Sherwood on his 20-yard, cuts up the middle, and it's off to the races. One man to beat, and he heads for the sidelines and gives everybody in the crowd a huge thrill. And it's not only 26 seconds into this ball game. We've had two touchdowns, and the score now is tied 6-6. Tory Daniels with the extra point. And the Gators lead 7-6, and they would not be headed again for the rest of the ball game. Brian McCusker calling signals. This was the premier game in the Big 30 this weekend. Scott Gearhart with a beautiful run up the middle for a touchdown. Gators starting to get some breathing room now. Again, Jimmy Stair in the hold. Bingo, kick is good, 14-6, and the rout is on. News media was there for this ball game. A nice crowd from Port Allegany, and they were treated to a Gator stomping of Ridgeway Elkers. Here we see a little bit of defense for the Gators, and what a defensive display they put on. Paul Robbins with the second interception of the ball game. And it was plays like these that earned him Big 30 Defensive Player of the Week. And here we'll see another play by Paul Robbins. Boom! That return man nowhere. Again, Bob Johnson for Ridgeway calling signals. Looking for someone to throw to. And he is pounded by that Gator defense. three, four, five Gators around that ball all the time, all afternoon. That is why they were number one in the Big 30 in defense. Another example of their tenacity. That Gator defensive line, best in the Big 30. This play, typical of Dick Sherwood in 1986. Heads for that sideline, and away he goes on another spectacular touchdown run. Dickie Sherwood showing you why he deserved to be Big 30 Player of the Year. The first player since Barry Bove back in the late 70s to run for over 1,000 yards in a Gator uniform. And again, Torrey Daniels in for the extra point. Some more defensive highlights. Beginning of the second half, the only play that Ridgeway could really run all day long, the Gators made a little defensive adjustment, and Brett Klein shut that one down as well. Some more heroics by that Gator defense. Oh, what a hit. Again, Paul Robbins out of that defensive halfback position. He played the game of his career this afternoon. And our old End Times Herald representative, Chuck Pollock, happened to see it. Again, track Kyle this time in on the tackle. And he, too, had a great afternoon for the Gators. Again, track Kyle's knocking the quarterback down, causing the fumble, recovering it for the Gators. If they could have given two awards, he deserved the second for Defensive Player of the Week. It was this type of play that typified Gator football in 1986. If you can't score by touchdown, send in Torrey Daniels with his toe, and bingo, three more points. Ridgeway made the mistake of commenting before this one that Port Allegany didn't deserve to be in the same league. Well, it looked like Ridgeway was playing in the wrong league in this afternoon. Again, another big play by the defense. Brett Klein picking off a pass over the middle, returning it all the way for a touchdown. Even though it was nullified, this just had to take the wind out of the sails of the Ridgeway Elkers. And now our quarterback of the future, Jimmy Stair. Again, dropping back to pass under tremendous pressure. Sees Tony Schall out in the flats, and it's off to the races. Touchdown, Gators. Final score, Gators 30, Ridgeway 6. Game 7 found the Gators in Emporium for a tough defensive battle with the Emporium Raiders. As you can see here, the Gator defense, again, stifling that Emporium offense. The Gators found the first half a little tough sledding. Emporium came out ready to play ball, and they stopped the Gator offense cold in the first half. Again, Gator defense looking to stifle that pass offense, and Dickie Sherwood with a near interception. Just couldn't hold on. The question in everyone's mind going into this game, would the Gators be up for Emporium after the big blowout of Ridgeway in the previous week? And like we mentioned before, the first half, the Gator offense was a bit sluggish, but their defense is what keeps them in ball games, and it played very, very well on this evening. This was the coldest night of the year, and even our cameraman had a tough time keeping everything in focus. Again, we see big defensive play by that Gator line, throwing the Cameron County Raider running back for a big loss. And track Kyle, along with Dale Budd in on that tackle. Gator offense trying to get something on track. Again, big inside handoff. This time, Paul Robbins down to the 35-yard line. And again, a big opening. It's off to the races for the Gators. Touchdown, Port Allegany, Paul Robbins. This would be the first of many on this evening for the Gator running back. Torrey Daniels extra point, and the Gators are out in front, 7-0. Gators were held on offense. Go for the punt. And again, it's that big hit that we've seen time after time. Paul Robbins decking that Cameron County runner. Jimmy Sarah in at quarterback near the end of the first half. He's rushed and he fumbles the ball. Cameron County gets the ball on the 6-yard line. Very little time remaining in the first half. Again, that Gator defense would be tested. One of the few times they weren't able to throw that shutout. Short little swing pass, touchdown Emporium. The extra point was no good. Port Allegany led 7-6. The beginning of the second half looked like the beginning of the Port Ridgeway ball game. But this time the hero is Paul Robbins, deep in Gator territory on a 10-yard line, bursts up the middle, and he's on his way for a 90-yard touchdown run. No one's going to catch Paul Robbins from behind. Touchdown, Gators. And the route is on. Again, big defensive pressure. Dickie Sherwood with that linebacker blitz. Blocked punt this time by the Gator defense. Recovered by that defensive line. Emporium was totally shackled in the second half. In a little counterplay that was one of the favorites of the Gators all year. And again, it's Robbins pulling the defender into the end zone. Touchdown. Previous week, Paul Robbins was Big 30 Defensive Player of the Week. He deserved to be Offensive Player of the Week this time around. And again, that little inside reverse, big burst up the middle, down to the 1-yard line. And it's a killer instinct by those Gators to put it right down their throat. Touchdown, Gators. Again, that Gator offensive squad, Big 30. There with a pass out in the fly. Good for a first down, a scene that will be seen for many years to come, hopefully on the Gator gridiron. Again, Stair rolling out. This time he pitches back. Touchdown, Port Allegany. Final score, Port Allegany 32, Emporium 6. On the Port Allegany Gators playing St. Mary's, their second night game in a row on a cold night but a clear night in St. Mary's against the St. Mary's Elk County Christian Crusaders. Again, Gator offense takes control of this ball game early. That's Gerhardt on that little inside reverse counterplay, and he's off to the races, and nobody's going to catch Scott from behind either. Torrey Daniels with that all-important extra point. And the Gators jump out to a 7-0 lead. This time, big run up the middle by Dick Sherwood. Good for another Gator first down. Elk County came into this ball game with a potent passing attack, and this is as close as they've come to scoring all night long, but the pass has dropped down along the 2-yard line. Elk County had given Smithport a beating earlier in the year and almost beat Johnsburg. And here we see Dickie Sherwood, beautiful blocking, tough running. Again, good for another Gator first down. The St. Mary's Elk team took Johnsonburg down to the wire and just lost in the last few seconds of the ballgame. And here again, Dick Sherwood showing why he gained over 1,000 yards. A pitch out, and this time again it's Sherwood up the middle. Look at him drag that player. 5-6 yards. RJ got up, but that player from St. Mary's did not on this play. Again, that vaunted running attack. This time McCusker pitching back to Sherwood. Beautiful one-hand catch. Touchdown, Gators. Torrey Daniels this time with a 25-yard extra point. And the way he was kicking this night, it could have been 35, 45 yards. It was good. Some more Gator offensive fireworks. Again, that little counter play. And it's off to the races. This time, Paul Robbins being led by Dick Sherwood. Just shows the teamwork that was involved with this Gator squad. Unselfish play of the teammates and the all-around play of the players. Again, inside handoff. Touchdown, Port Allegany. And again, that all-important extra point. And the Gators were well on their way to a big stomping of the Elk County Christian Crusader. And Dick Sherwood from his linebacker spot. And again, it's another touchdown. Beautiful return, 25 yards. And the Gators were rolling. The extra point was good. Jimmy Stair this time. Tony Schell over the middle, a play that we've seen several times this year. And again, result, 6 points. Touchdown. Little quarterback keeper. And again, Port Allegany touchdown. Tony Schell this time in for the extra point. Kick is up. And good. Final score, Port Allegany 42, St. Mary's nothing. Was on to week number 9, Port Allegany versus Smithport, the rivalry that rivals none in the Big 30. This game is a tremendous ball game. No matter who's winning or who has a losing record, doesn't matter. Throw them out the window, because either one of these teams can come up a winner in this rivalry. It's also homecoming week. There's a lot of excitement in the air, and it was a big ball game. The Gators already won their division of the Allegheny Mountain League, and now they wanted to cap it off with a perfect season versus the Hubbers of Smithport. Plus, they had a payback coming. Smithport beat the Gators in 1985, and the Gators wanted to write the only blemish on that record from 1985. Smithport starts out on offense. Tosino looking to pass, and again, a big defensive play from that defensive half-back spot, Brian McCusker. Knocking that pass away. Again, Smithport on offense. This time, the quarterback under tremendous pressure, and it's again the Gator defense knocks the ball down. Gators have to give the ball up on downs. Brett Klein, tremendous job all year of punting. And this time, it's Ray Roberts with a great tackle, open field tackle, bringing Tosina down for no gain on that return. Port Allegany will find itself in an unfamiliar spot. They get behind early. This play by Bruce Tosina show why he's one of the players of the future in the Allegheny Mountain League. Long touchdown run, and Smithport jumps out to a 6-0 lead over the Gators. This play is also for the highlight films. An extra point attempt that goes off the upright. Very few times do you see that happen. Doink, and it's no good. Again, that Gator offense trying to get something on track. They needed a big play at this point, and they get one. Brian McCusker hooking up with Todd Higley with the longest pass play of the 1986 season for the Gators. And Higley down to the 9-yard line before he's finally collared. But that got the Gators out of a big hole and opened up that running attack for the Gators that Smithport up to this point was able to stop. Again, that pitch back to Dickie Sherwood, looking to get outside, trying to get into that end zone, and he's taken down. Finally, the Gators get in position, and Brian McCusker scores, and the Gators tie the ball game up at 6-6. Some happy people in the end zone. Again, Smithport trying to get their offense on track. Going to the airwaves. Beautiful interception this time. Brian McCusker. First and 10, Port Allegany. And that defense now is rising to the occasion once more. Little pitch back. Dickie Sherwood coming at us and heading for the sideline. Big first down, Port Allegany. And those Gators trying to put the old chokehold on Smithport. Again, it's Brian McCusker dropping back the pass, and he finds Paul Robbins open out in the flat. And Robbins down to the 23-yard line, first and 10 Gators. And again, that Gator offense trying to get that ball in the end zone. And it's Scott Gearhart, who should have won Unsung Hero of the Year award in a big 30. Touchdown. And he puts the Gators out in front. And the extra point, and that makes the score 13-6, Port Allegany. Time and time we saw Scott Gearhart come through with a big play when the Gators needed one. When teams were double-teaming Dickie Sherwood and Paul Robbins, it'd be Gearhart with a big run. Time for Gator defense. What a defensive day they had. Quarterback Thomas sacked for another loss. This time Shag Ramadan, along with Scott Taylor in on that play. Again, a quick kick, and it's blocked. Shag Ramadan with a beautiful block on the quick kick, and the Gators take over on the 21-yard line. First time all year Port had a quick kick tried on them, and it backfired. And again, that little pitch out, taking the ball in for a TD, and you can see his father happy as ever. Big lead. The extra point by Torrey Daniels is good. Score is 20-6, and the route is on. And again, Dickie Sherwood with a big straight arm coming up. Bingo! Throws the guy off like a rag doll, and it's just a foot race to the end zone. Touchdown, Gators. What a homecoming this turned out to be. Port Allegany going for that extra point. And again, Torrey Daniels out of Jimmy Stairs' hold. Down and good. Port Allegany 27, Smithport 6. That's the way the ball game ended. And a big congratulations going all around to those Gator coaches. Coaching staff of the year as far as we're concerned. Especially the redhead, the smaller one of the two. Up next for the Gators, that all-important date in 2 weeks with the Johnsonburg Rams. What a game this would turn out to be. Time after time. It was on to Emporium, Pennsylvania for the first ever Allegheny Mountain League championship. Combatants, of course, the Port Allegany Gators with a record of 9-0, going against the Johnsonburg Rams, who surprised a lot of people this year with a record of 10-0. Johnsonburg commanded this ball game, rated the top school in mid-sized schools in the Big 30. The Gators ranked number 2. How they come up with these rankings is more than we'll figure out. We won't even try to. But the Gators come in with a number 1 defense in the Big 30 against scoring, and the number 1 offense in the Big 30 scoring points, an average of 30 points a ball game. And the Gators were looking to become the first champions of the Allegheny Mountain League. It was a wet, rainy night in Emporium. Both coaches were hoping that this type of weather wouldn't hinder the play, and as it turned out, the weather did not stop these players from putting on a fantastic display of football prowess. Here we have the historic first coin toss of this ball game. Port Allegany was the visiting team on this evening. And representing the Gators for the last time would be R.J. Sherwood, along with his co-captain, Greg Rapp. Representing Johnsonburg was number 14, Tim Myers, who turned out to be the Offensive Player of the Year in the Big 30, and 79, Dave Selleck. One aspect of this ball game, along with the wet weather, was for the second weekend in November, it was a fairly warm night, and this did allow for the players to be able to hold on to the football and to catch a lot of passes. And the opening kickoff, Johnsonburg did win the coin toss, elected to receive, and they come back out to about the 25-yard line. First and 10 for Johnsonburg. And everybody in the stadium, 5,000 people lining this sidelines and in the stands for this game, knew exactly what Johnsonburg was going to do. They relied totally on the arm of Tim Myers, and this play will show you why. A little flare pass out to Lobaugh, and it's off to the races. Brian McCusker finally pushes him out of bounds down around the Gator 15-yard line. Again, Myers calling signals and showing why he was chosen Big 30 Player of the Year. Rolling out to his left, throwing against the grain, touchdown to Kilhoffer, and the Rams jump out to a 6-0 lead on the Gators. That all-important extra point. Snap down, and Torrey Daniels bursts through the middle to block it. So the Gators escape with only a 6-0 deficit at this point. Again, Johnsonburg held Port Allegany, and they're driving. Kilhoffer on the pitch out. But again, that Gator defense showing us why it was ranked number 1 in the Big 30. And they've got to come up with some big plays now, or else they're digging a big hole for that Gator offense to try to climb out of. Again, Myers with a little quick two-step pitch out. But this time, Lobaugh fumbles the ball. And the Gators recover. They have stopped Johnsonburg and gained some momentum. This was a game of momentum, ebb and tide back and forth. And now time for some Gator offense. And again, trying to crank up the ground game. Little inside handoff, good for 9 yards. Again, hitting at that line. And again, a big first down. Before the game, it was predicted Port could run on this team, and run they did. And again, a big hitter up the middle for another 6-7 yards. Port Allegany on the night would come close to 400 yards on the ground. That little counter play, this time Scott Gearhart, a beautiful hurdle of a tackler, and he's off to the races, and no one's going to catch this young man from behind. big 48-yard run. Touchdown, Gators, and the score is tied at 6-6. Snap, hold. The kick is no good. One of the few times in 86 that we saw Torrey Daniels miss. And the score now is tied at 6 apiece. Again, Myers trying to generate some offense here. Inside handoff to Kilhoffer, which goes nowhere. That Gator defense starting to stiffen. Again, Johnsonburg on offense. Myers dropping back to pass. Big rush and a beautiful hit along the sidelines by that Gator defense. You know that pro set, the I formation. Myers rolling under big pressure. And this time the pass is batted away again. Again, Myers rolling out. Looking for someone to throw to. And again, almost picked off by that Gator defense. Port Allegany back on offense. The Gators looking to try to get out on top in this ball game. Big inside handoff. This time Paul Robbins fighting for that extra yardage. Big 20-yard gain, first and 10, Port Allegany. Quick hitter up the middle, this time Dick Sherwood, and it's a touchdown for Port Allegany. This time, they're not about to miss the extra point. Gators 13, Johnsonburg 6 at this juncture. One of the few times this evening that the Gator defense broke down. A big pass play down the middle. The only player close enough to catch the ball carrier was McCusker, and they finally ran him out of bounds deep in Gator territory. First and 10, Johnsonburg. And they're knocking on the door again. Again. And a big interception this time. And the Gators held Johnsonburg. But they coughed the ball right back up with a big fumble. And this time it hurts because Johnsonburg gets the ball back deep in Gator territory. Again, Myers calling signals. Dropping back to pass. Great protection. This time, Todd Moses with a big interception, filling in for an injured Paul Robbins. First and 10, Port Allegany. This time, on a punt, the center snap goes out of the end zone, and Johnsonburg takes a big one-point lead against the Gators, 14-13. And that's how the half ended, 14-13. We missed a touchdown. Second half, all year long, has been the Gator half. And here we see another Brett Klein punt. And again, a big hit down on the would-be ball carrier. Ray Roberts stopping him dead in his tracks. Johnsonburg trying to get that offense loosened up, and again, beautiful play this time by Brian McCusker. The defensive adjustments by the Gators was fantastic for the second half. Johnsonburg completed two passes a whole half, as we shall see later. Again, Paul Robbins this time on a punt return. He stopped. No, he's not. He comes out of there, and he heads for the sideline. Again, just a tremendous run by Paul Robbins, picking up an additional 10 yards on second, third effort for the Gators. And this play, again, Dickey Sherwood up the middle, and this is the backbreaker, folks. Dickey Sherwood's going to go 73 yards for a touchdown, and he's going to put the Gators out in front for good. Touchdown, Gators. The all-important extra point is good, and now the score, 20-14. Again, Johnsonburg trying to get their offense on track here in the second half. And the Gators showing why that defense is ranked number one in the Big 30, putting tremendous pressure on Myers. And he is sacked for a 2-3 yard loss by that Gator defense. And again, Myers looking for someone to pass to, throws out in the flat, and Jimmy Stair with a big interception. Running the ball down the sideline, one player to beat, and he's finally tackled out of bounds at the 34-yard line. Plays like this broke the necks of the Johnsonburg Rams. Myers would be intercepted 5 times on the night. And the Gator defense again showing why it's number one. This time Brian McCusker, little quarterback keeper, heading for that goal line, and he almost makes it in, much to the delight of the big crowd from Port Allegany on the side. And here's the nails in the coffin of Johnsonburg. Torrey Daniels with a big field goal to put this game out of reach, and Port Allegany is now up by 9 points, 23-14. And again, the Gator fans going wild. Again, Myers looking to throw, throwing deep, and Paul Robbins picking this one off. And the Gators now can start savoring the victory that is close at hand. And again, Myers trying to get that offense into the end zone under tremendous pressure. He was all night. And again, it's picked off by that Gator defense. Looks like a number one ball club to me. And again, the celebration begins, ladies and gentlemen. And there you have it, the 1986 Allegheny Mountain League champion, Port Allegany Gators.
Champion comes home at your own high school.
Couldn't feel greater. Really a great feeling, and you know, everything that we've done and over the years seems to be well rewarded, and naturally our kids are really enjoying it.
Okay, good. We're glad.
Thanks.
All right, by the way, the kids wanted me to ask a question of you. Are you going to give them the day off from school Monday morning?
No.
No way, huh?
We'll be there.
Can't I twist your arm a little bit?
No, we'll be there.
Okay, we have the quarterback's father sitting right here, the guy that commanded this team almost all season long. What do you think of your son's play this evening?
It was a good game. They all played very well.
How about that last play that Brian pulled where he had the keeper and went down the sideline? Did your heart jump a little bit?
No, I was surprised he had it. I wasn't sure he had it until I saw him keep on going.
Boy, he sure did a fine job, and he did a lot of growth this year, didn't he?
Yes, he did. It was a good year for him.
That's a fine way to end one senior year, isn't it?
It sure is. Now, on to basketball now.
Absolutely. That's coming up shortly, about another month. Who was, first of all, the guy that had this winning coach, Bob Haskins, on the previous teams, if I recall correctly, and also had him underneath him. What about tonight's win?
We expected it all the way, really. I think you can verify that, Lee. I showed you my poster I made in school on Friday.
That's for sure.
And if you recall, it said, Gators were the king of the hill.
And they sure are king of the hill. Have any comments about tonight's action, play patterns, and so forth?
Well, this is a normal, hard-hitting ball game. And the Port players are in a tradition where they have always hit, and this team changed nothing. They're still good hitters.
You got to kind of be proud of this because of having had Bobby underneath you as a player and then as an assistant coach, and now seeing him as a head coach, having turned around from last four seasons ago. Last year successful with an 8-1, and this year 10-0 all the way to the top.
All the way to the top, but you know that's an all Port Allegany staff. All five of those boys are Port Allegany graduates, and they all play football, and they all play football well. And of course, Bobby's a little special because he came in when things were a little rough and kept the tradition going to a winner now.
Yep. Well, thank you a lot, Coach Burrow. Enjoy the evening. Yeah, we're waiting for the football team here at the fire hall to show up from less than this.
We really didn't have it together at the beginning, but I think we got it together the second half. We did what we had to do.
Yeah, you sure did. How are you feeling now?
I'm a little sore, but I don't really notice at the moment.
You took a couple of pretty good licks tonight. Understand it bothered your hearing somewhat. Everything okay now?
Yeah, it's fine. I can hear real good again.
Okay, fine. You must be pretty pleased with yourself. You had a good game tonight.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, you did. You did a pretty good job busting out there. And, boy, that last interception you pulled.
It took a whole team effort, though. It's just not one person.
Oh, that's always true. But, boy, it looks good when you do something that's outstanding, and you guys had a terrific game. Congratulations.
Thank
hitting
you.
Game, they came right at you, didn't they?
Yeah, well.
As one of your cohorts said, it was a team effort all together. How you feel about that, guys?
We're good.
Was great.
Yeah.
Was a great time, man.
Quite a last play you pulled on your senior year, right?
Yes.
Down the sideline. You were really stretching for the goal line, weren't you?
Yeah, I saw it going. I just couldn't get in there.
You almost got it there, fella.
Go,
boy,
go.
A lot of growth this year. RJ, you kind of broke their back with that 75-yard run that you pulled.
Yeah, I just cut to the offensive line. They really had some good blocking for me tonight.
Oh, they did. They sprung you out of there. You know, actually, the Rams seemed like they just kind of lost you.
Didn't you know where you were? They had trouble. It was a wet game. It was a good one. Love the team, and it was nice playing with them.
Yep. Congratulations, guys. That game, don't you?
Yeah.
Hey, you had quite an interception there. Sort of took the wind right out of their sails there for a moment, didn't you?
Yeah, he hit me right in the numbers. I couldn't drop it.
Absolutely. Good job.
Thank you.
We're going to grab Coach Askins out of here. Come on over here, Bobby. Boy, looks like you've been out on the field. How did it feel?
Great.
Any words of wisdom about this team tonight?
They just played super all year. Tonight was just the ultimate.
Yeah, well, tonight was more than super, boy. You had a tough time. That Johnsonburg Rams came right at you guys.
Yeah, we knew he'd throw.
Yeah? Particularly any outstanding things about tonight's game?
Diggy sure was just outstanding again. 171 yards rushing. The whole team played well. Torrey Daniels had a nice game defensively. You can just go right down the line.
Yeah, boy, we talked to some of the guys as they've come in. Paul Robbins, interceptions, Todd Moses with interceptions. Boy, those guys, and Johnsonburg was really coming at you guys through the air, weren't they?
Oh, yeah, that's the only way they can move the ball. Well, in the second half, he had to go to it. The ground game was shut down for him, so he had to throw the ball.
Yeah, you had made the comment that this was going to be a classic game, and it sure was, wasn't it? Coach Turner, offensive coach, how does this win feel?
Doesn't that say it?
That says it all. You missed his sign over there, folks. You had your hands full offensively, didn't you?
Well, not really, Mr. Bennett. I thought we handled them pretty well. We did everything we wanted to do. We just turnovers.
Just the turnovers, huh?
Kept them in the game. That's right. We moved the ball. We must have had 300 yards rushing. Our backs ran well.
A lot of that came from R.J. Sherwood, didn't it?
Yes, it did. Well,
when that line sprung him loose.
Yes, and Paul ran an outstanding game. You know, both those backs ran like they were possessed.
Oh, absolutely. You can see it from up on top where we were filming it.
Yeah. We were happy with them.
Well, you got to be. This is a great victory, Jim. Seeing that Ed helped engineer this thing, and then the first champions come home to our own high school, and all of you guys on this staff are former players of this football team of the Port Allegany High.
Well, that's true.
Yeah, absolutely.
That makes
everyone.
It nice, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Good job, Jim.
Thanks a lot.
Gentlemen, this is getting to be a bedlam behind us right now. This is a culmination of a winning season for the Gators football squad. They're really excited and enthused about what they've done. They came back, as Coach Burrow said, king of the mountain. This is the first championship of the Allegheny Mountain League. And right now we're going to have a few words, I guess, by Coach Askins.
Very enthusiastic crowd here this evening. And he's turning over the mic now to Coach Turner.
And we'll have a moment to see what else Coach Turner might add, especially speaking to this hometown crowd. Having played football here, been raised here, and of course, as all the guys have, been raised in this area.
I'm really impressed. I mean, it's all year long, you know, we talk to the boys, and we play a game, and we look around in the stands, and it's always looked sparsely populated. But I guess we had a much loyal following than we really anticipated. I know the boys were impressed, and we really thank you for an awful nice welcome. And I'm going to end. You know, there's nothing I can say. I just want to relate to you. I said in the pep assembly not too many weeks ago that these bunch of boys are the best team in the Big 30. And
boy, and that's for sure. The papers need to. Been hard-pressed to get any press coverage, and now the question has been answered as whether or not this football team from the Port Allegany High School was for real. They sure are. They are now champions of the Allegheny Mountain League. They've met the best, which was Johnsonburg out of the Western Division of that league, of this new league, and now the Eastern Division champions have become the champions of
roses, no pleasure cruise.